Hi everyone, it's Aunt Fernita. Today's story is called Nehemiah, God's Builder. The memory verse is from Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 8. It says, "The gracious hand of my God was upon me." Today's message is God gives me the grace and power to do His will. How come the pastor is always asking for money? Jessica wanted to know. Because our church family has outgrown its old church and we need a new one, answered Dad. It takes money and a lot of people willing to help build, he explained. It reminds me of Nehemiah rebuilding Jerusalem's walls. I'm so glad to see you again, Nehemiah exclaimed, hugging his brother Hanani. Hanani had recently arrived with others from Judah. How are you? How are the rest of the Jews surviving back in Jerusalem? The smile left Hanani's face. Not well, he said sadly. The wall around Jerusalem has been torn down. The gates have all been burned. Enemies could walk right in and attack God's people. Nehemiah sank into a chair. Tears spilled down his cheeks. For the next few weeks, Nehemiah mourned. He fasted and he prayed. Oh Lord, he pleaded, listen to my prayer. I am going to ask the king for a great favor. Please put it into his heart to be kind to me. One evening, Nehemiah went to work as usual. He carried the king's drink to him at the dinner table. The king looked up. Why do you look so sad tonight? He asked. Long live the king, Nehemiah exclaimed. I am sad because the city where my ancestors are buried is in ruins. How can I help you? The king asked kindly. Nehemiah prayed a quick, silent prayer. Then he answered the king. Please send me to Judah to rebuild the city where my ancestors are buried. Nehemiah took a big breath. He had more to ask. Oh, king, please give me a letter to the manager of your forest. Tell him to give me wood so I can build. I will rebuild the city gates and the walls and a house for myself. The king wrote the letter. Then he ordered army officers and soldiers on horseback to go with Nehemiah. They would protect him on the long, long journey to Jerusalem. Finally, Nehemiah reached Jerusalem. After staying there for 3 days, he rode his donkey around at night to look at the damage. He found that he couldn't even ride through some of the gates into the city. They were plugged with big rocks that had been part of the wall. Then Nehemiah spoke to the city leaders. He told them about the king and how God had helped him so far. Let's rebuild the wall of Jerusalem, he exclaimed. So the people began the work, and they worked hard. But their enemies made plans to attack and kill the Jews. The Jews prayed and asked God to protect them. Then Nehemiah told them to get their swords, their spears, and their bows and arrows. They would guard the wall with one hand and work with the other. Don't be afraid of the enemy. Remember the Lord, Nehemiah encouraged them. Many times the enemies tried to stop the rebuilding work. Nehemiah prayed constantly, and God gave him the wisdom to know what to do. The work continued, and the wall was finished in just 52 days. God blessed this project in many ways. He gave Nehemiah courage to ask the king for help. He gave the workers power to carry on their rebuilding. God truly led his people.
This podcast is read by Franita Buddy for gracelink.net. Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. Post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. Animation and artwork by Giogo Godoy. The audio engineer was Karel Holness. For more information, please visit gracelink.net.